The perpendiculars from center upon the tangents and normal at any point of the hyperbola meets them in Q and R. We need to find locus of Q and R. So Q is foot of perpendicular on tangent, and R is foot of perpendicular on normal. So first we'll find locus of Q. Let this point be P, which is A secant theta and B tan theta. And let this point Q be alpha comma beta. Now, what is the slope of OQ? Slope of OQ is beta upon alpha. Slope of PQ will be minus alpha upon beta. We can write equation of PQ as y minus beta, and it'll be minus alpha upon beta x minus alpha. So we'll write this equation as y equals minus alpha upon beta x plus alpha square plus beta square upon beta. Now this line is actually tangent to hyperbola. Now condition of tangency is c square, it must be equal to a square m square minus b square. Now c in this case is alpha square plus beta square upon beta. So it'll be alpha square plus beta square upon beta whole square, and it'll be equal to a square. And what's m square? M square is alpha square upon beta square minus b square. Now we'll simplify this. We can write this as alpha square plus beta square whole square, and it'll be equal to a square alpha square minus b square beta square. So locus of this point Q, it will be x square plus y square whole square, and it is equal to a square x square minus b square y square. Now we'll find locus of this point R. Now in the same way, if we take this point as h comma k, then equation of PR, it will be y equals minus h upon kx plus h square plus k square upon k. Now we know that equation of normal in terms of slope is given by y equals mx plus minus m a square plus b square upon under root of a square minus m square b square. Now both these lines, they represent the same normal. So we'll compare, we'll get m as minus h upon k, and we'll get h square plus k square upon k, and it'll be equal to plus minus m a square plus b square upon under root of a square minus m square b square. Now we'll square it and cross multiply. So we can write this as h square plus k square whole square, and it'll be a square minus, now what's m square? M square will be h square upon k square b square, and then we'll have k square, m square is h square upon k square, and then a square plus b square whole square. Now here k square will cancel, so we can write this result as h square plus k square whole square, and it'll be a square k square minus h square b square, it'll be hk whole square into a square plus b square whole square. Now we'll replace h with x and k with y. So this locus will be x square plus y square whole square a square x square minus b square y square xy square into a square plus b square whole square. And that is the locus of R.